I'm Sasha Chua, and welcome to Emacs Conf 2020. To kick things off, here are 10 cool things that people have been working on since the conference last year. If you want to follow the links, or if you'd like to add something I've missed, add them to the collaborative pad if you're watching this live, or check out the Emacs Conf wiki page for this talk. The big news this year was the release of Emacs 27.1, a little over 2 years after Emacs 26. Mickey Peterson's notes in the release are a great way to find out what's new, and John Wigley's development update tomorrow will probably give more details. What's coming up for Emacs 28 and beyond? One of the branches that people are excited about is GCC Emacs, which compiles Emacs Lisp to native code so that it runs faster. To learn more, check out the Bringing New Emacs to Native Code presentation from the European Lisp Symposium. There was a huge conversation about modernizing Emacs on Emacs Devel and other places. Linux Weekly News has a good summary. One of the interesting subthreads on Emacs Devel was about using more variable width fonts, which would probably go a long way to making Emacs look pretty fancy once people sort out the alignment issues. It looks like Core Emacs will probably change slowly in terms of functionality and documentation, but starter kits and configuration give people a great way to experiment. Speaking of starter kits, Doom Emacs seems to be growing in popularity. It got a big boost thanks to Doomcast and DistroTube videos, so if you're curious, go ahead and check those out. And for general Emacs topics, there have been a ton of other great videos from Protasilao Stavro, Mike Zabansky, System Crafters, and other folks. Good stuff. Org continues to be a big reason for people to get into Emacs. This year, Zettelkasten-based workflows became popular as people played around with organizing ideas into small chunks that are linked to each other. OrgRome is one of the packages for doing that, and there are 3 presentations about it this year. There are also non-org ways to do it, such as Zetteldef, Neuron Mode, and more. People have been experimenting with org's appearance. Check out these screenshots for some ideas. Faster JSON processing is going to make working with code analysis tools better. LSP Mode released version 7 and gained more contributors too, so there are probably exciting times ahead for making Emacs even more of an integrated development environment. EAF, or the Emacs Application Framework, has some pretty interesting demos of embedded Qt programs in Emacs on Linux. Matthew Zhang will give a presentation on its architecture and walk through some demos, so check that one out too if you want. The big real-world change this year was COVID-19, of course. It sucks. A lot. One good thing that's come out of it is that many Emacs meetups have moved online, so it's easier to connect with people no matter where you are in the world. There's one hosted by Emacs ATX on December 2, and it's about RE Builder, Leaf, and Feather. Emacs NYC's next meetup is on December 7, and it's about literate programming with Org Mode. The Berlin Remote Meetup was just a few days ago on November 25, and Emacs SF and Asia Pacific probably have some coming up too. People generally announce the meetups on reddit.com/r/emacs, so you can look there for updates. If you organize one of these, please let me know so I can include it in Emacs News. Lastly, there's an unofficial survey of the Emacs community. It closes on November 30, so if you'd like to participate, you can fill out the form at emacssurvey.org or send it in via email. So those were 10 quick highlights from this year. If you're curious, check out the Emacs Conf 2020 wiki page for this talk so you can follow the links. If you'd like to get updates every week, you can check out the Emacs news I put together. Feel free to send me cool stuff to include. Now on to the rest of Emacs Conf. Have fun and thanks for joining us!